Good morning, dear friends. Today I am going to explain the accounting treatment of bad debts. See, debtors are persons who owe money to the business. From the accounting viewpoint, debts are classified into three. They are good debts, doubtful debts, and bad debts. Before explaining the accounting treatment of bad debts, I like to give you the story of bad debts. Please listen to this story. David is a businessman. One day, one of his customers, Paul, visited him. Security staff of David saw Paul. Security staff entered the chamber of David and said, "Sir, an HDL came." Paul overheard this. After the official discussion, Paul asked David about why security staff remarked him as HDL. David said, "It's our secret code. We are giving credit sales to our customers. Customers due money to us. Our customers are like cholesterol. Some are HDL, but some others are LDL. Like good cholesterol, HDL are our good customers and good debts. Like bad cholesterol, LDL are our bad customers, that is our bad debts." Then suddenly another customer entered into the chamber and said to David, "Did you receive my check?" A little bit angry, David replied, "Yes, twice." When that customer went out, Paul asked David, "Your reply was, 'Yes, twice.' How can you receive a check twice? What did you mean by that?" David replied, "I received his check twice, one from him. After that, I submitted that check to my bank. My bank sent it for collection. Check became dishonored. My bank gave it back to me, marked 'Dishonored, payment doubtful.' Then I received that check twice, one from him and thereafter from the bank. He is a doubtful customer." Here ends our story. See, bad debt means irrecoverable debt. Irrecoverable portion of debtors is termed as bad debts. Bad debt is a loss to the business. As per the basic rule, expenses and losses increase is debited. Therefore, bad debt is debited in the books of accounts. Journal entry is bad debts account debtor to sundry debtors account. Bad debts should be shown on the debit side of the profit and loss account. And again, it should be deducted from sundry debtors at the asset side of the balance sheet. I hope that all of you enjoyed this presentation. Please point out your comments in the comment box. Please be kind enough to subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching. Bye. See you again.